Behind the War got the opportunity to talk with General Mull of the American Revolution. The general gave us an insight in the life and times of soldiers during the war.
Hi, my name is General Mull. I am a member of the United States Militia of Division 16. Now here we are, training our troops for the American Revolution. Now what you're about to see, oh hi! General Mogan, here I am having my cup of tea. Now, you may be wondering, what kind of weapons did the U.S. troops use during the American Revolution? Well, I'm here to tell you that. Well, they used guns, 3 to 6 pound cannons, sabers, and they did these drills, you see, from 6 a.m. to 8, at 1, at 3, and 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Now that's a lot of exercising, don't you think? I do. Now, they also did an exercise called the quick step. That was torture.
The general takes a break and decides to watch the History Channel. But once the program is over, she demonstrates some of the exercises soldiers did to prepare for the war.
Catching up on a little history, because after all, history rocks. So does cross country. Now, I'm going to tell you how U.S. troops of the American Revolution fought. Okay, here we go.
Now that you're out of my life, I'm so much better. You thought that I'd be weak without you, but I'm stronger.
Now let's find out some more information about the American Revolution from our very own General Mo. So, General Mo, what kind of techniques did you use to capture the British?
On the orders of General Putnam, we fortified Breed's Hill and Bunker Hill. That's right. We took it over.
So, General Mo, what was the American view of British troops?
See, they thought we were inexperienced and that we didn't have that many supplies, but we proved them wrong whenever we invaded Canada. Mm-hmm. Yep. See, what we did was, can you believe that? Yeah.
So tell us, how did you overtake the British in America?
We had the advantage. Well, number one, see, in November of 1775, General George Washington convinced the Continental Congress to allow blacks to enter the Continental Army. With their help, we were able to trick them British. You see, the thing is, what we did was we snuck up behind them from trees and stone walls and stuff, and we shot at them. They used their muskets while the U.S. troops He is their hunt.
How did the Continental Army become successful?
Under the watchful eye of General George Washington, the U.S. troops became experienced after really, really hard training. And we began to win battle after battle after battle. So then, we crossed the Delaware many times, including one time when we defeated those Hessians. See, one night they were getting drunk, they fell asleep, and we snuck up in the middle of the night, and boom! Blew them away.
Wow, I've learned so much already, but I can't wait to hear, how did the American Revolution end?
The British surrendered in Virginia, and they sued for a peace treaty. So, U.S. troops won the American Revolution.